Hi guys, welcome back to my channel The AG. In today's video, I am going to share you a Sankranti recipe, that is Arisalu. Arisalu is usually prepared during Pongal and I love this recipe. Let's get started and prepare this yummy and delicious Arisalu recipe. This whole process of cooking involves another person also. So here I am taking help of my mom while preparing this Arisalu. So to prepare Arisalu, let's soak rice to prepare rice flour. Here you have to prepare wet rice flour. To prepare wet rice flour, here I am soaking 2 kgs of rice. You have to soak this rice for 24 to 36 hours in a container. Before you soak the rice in a container, make sure that you clean the rice twice till water runs clear. Cover the lid and soak this rice for 36 hours. For every 6 to 8 hours, make sure that you change the water so that your rice doesn't smell. Add fresh water and soak the rice for 36 hours. After 36 hours, remove the lid and drain the excess water and clean the rice completely. Now add fresh water and drain the water from the rice. Leave the rice for 5 to 10 minutes aside and we shall prepare fine powder with this rice. If the quantity is large, you can either take this rice to the flour mill and make it into fine powder, or else you can make into fine powder with the help of a mixer grinder. Here I am using a mixer grinder to prepare fine rice powder. Sieve this rice powder in order to get extra fine rice powder. Do not add rice powder which is granule. So here sieving the rice is very important. Sieve the entire quantity of rice flour and keep this aside. Keep a wet cloth on the rice flour container so that the moisture from the rice flour doesn't escape. Now we shall prepare jaggery syrup. To prepare jaggery syrup, I took about 1 kg of grated jaggery. For 1 kg of grated jaggery, I added 1 cup of water and keep the flame on high and mix well to prepare jaggery syrup. After 10 minutes, if you see, all the jaggery has melted, and at this stage switch off the flame. Now filter this jaggery syrup to remove small dust particles which are accumulated with jaggery. So if you see, there are small dust and dirt particles in the jaggery. So after removing this dirt and dust particles from the jaggery, transfer to the same bowl, keep the flame on medium to high and mix continuously till you get perfect jaggery consistency. After 5 minutes, if you drop a little quantity of jaggery syrup in a bowl of water, jaggery syrup whole shape. This is the perfect consistency for making Arisalu. Switch off the flame and add 1 teaspoon of cardamom powder and add 2 teaspoons of ghee. Mix well and add wet rice flour. We have to add wet rice flour continuously and mix this rice flour with the jaggery syrup continuously to avoid lump. This process should be very quick enough so that the jaggery syrup doesn't cool down completely. If this jaggery syrup has cooled down completely, you cannot make Arisalu properly. So make sure that you take help of another person while you are adding rice flour. The person who is mixing the jaggery and rice flour should be quick enough so that all the rice flour get well mixed with the jaggery. Depending on different qualities of jaggery and the rice flour, jaggery syrup absorbs more rice flour while you are adding rice flour at this stage. So make sure that you soak an extra of 2 kgs. As shown in the video, I took 2 kgs of rice flour for 1 kg of jaggery. So make sure that you soak extra quantity of rice flour and keep that aside so that it will be useful while you are adding to the jaggery. Mix the jaggery and the rice flour till it gets well combined and forms single dough like consistency. Now add 2 teaspoons of ghee and mix well. Cover the lid and keep this aside. At this stage, be a little quick so that while this batter has completely cooled down, arsalu will not form and they will break while you drop it in the oil. So cover the lid and keep this aside. Now we shall heat the oil on high flame and drop little quantity of the batter to check if the batter consistency is correct or not. We mix our arsalu batter properly, it holds the shape and it floats in the oil. This means that we have made arsalu batter in perfect consistency and we are good to make arsalu. Now keep the flame on medium and let's spread arsalu. To prepare arsalu, take a flat surface and keep a butter paper or an oil cover. Here I am using an oil cover which has oil on it. So take small quantity of arsalu batter and press gently with the help of palms and fingers to make into a round shape. Drop this into oil carefully. Do not put any spoon or ladle until it floats by itself in the oil. When this one floats in the oil, then keep the ladle and turn into other side and fry evenly on both the sides till they turn into golden brown color. When bubbles in the oil disappear, this means that our harissa is completely cooked from inside and we are ready to remove from the oil. Remove this harissa from the oil and transfer it to a perforated plate where you can press and remove excess oil. This tool is used to remove excess oil after you fry this harissa. Flip and press gently on both the sides and remove excess oil and keep them aside and store this in an aerated jar. Now we shall prepare the second one. In the same method, take small quantity, press it gently to make a round shape and drop this harissa carefully into the oil. If you see this harissa fluffed up in the oil, this is a good sign that we have made a perfect consistency of harissa batter and this harissa has fried well on both the sides. Take it out from the oil and keep it on this tool and press gently to remove the excess oil. That's it, your yummy and delicious plain harissa is ready. Now we shall prepare harissa with sesame seeds. Here, this recipe is usually prepared during winter season, so the combination of jaggery and sesame seeds is very good for our health. Take small quantity of harissa batter and roll the ball in sesame seeds and press gently on the oil paper. Now after you make into round shape, remove the harissa from the paper and drop it in the oil carefully. If you see, the harissa floats by itself in the oil. After harissa floats itself in the oil, flip and fry on the other side till it turns into golden brown color. Make sure that you keep the flame on medium so that it turns into even golden brown color. This, look how beautiful our sesame seeds harissa. So I love this sesame seeds harissa. After cooking all these arisalu, place them in an aerated jar by placing in a tissue paper at the bottom. You can store this arisalu for about 2 to 3 months if you use good quality of ingredients. Using good quality of ingredients enhances the taste and life of this dish. So make sure that you use good quality of products while you're making such delicious festival recipes. Enjoy this crispy and delicious sweet recipe arisalu this pongal. Please like this video and support our channel. I hope you like this recipe and do follow these small tips and tricks to get delicious arisalu, and I hope you enjoy this pongal. I hope you definitely love these recipes. If you do like this recipe, please try it out for this Sankranti and do let me know how this turned out to you in comment section below. If you're first time to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more interesting videos. And once again, wish you a very happy pongal from our channel, The AAG.